हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर हिस्ट्री क्लास. चिल्ड्रेन, वी हैड ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 2 ऑफ हिस्ट्री, हिस्टोरियोग्राफी, इंडियन ट्रेडिशन. इन पार्ट 1 वी हैड लर्नड अबाउट हिस्टोरियोग्राफी इन द एंशिएंट पीरियड एंड हिस्टोरियोग्राफी इन द मेडिवल पीरियड. इन द एंशिएंट पीरियड द पीपल दे हैड प्रिजर्व्ड हिस्ट्री विद द हेल्प ऑफ oral recitals. Then we learnt about the inscriptions which were found on the copper plate, then on the coins, etc. We also learnt about the Indian ancient literature like Ramayana, Mahabharata, Buddhist text, then travelogues written by foreign travelers. These all were the important sources of history that we had learned in the historiography in the ancient period. Then we had also covered historiography in the medieval period, wherein there were many historians who had written about the Mughal rulers, about the Mughal period, etc. The Bakhars, which were written by Sabhasad Bakhar, which was written by Krishnaji Anand Sabhasad, Panipatasi Bakhar, Holkaransi Kaifiyat. We had learned about that in the historiography in the medieval period. Today, we will start with historiography in the modern period. There were many British historians who had written about our Indian history. Okay, let us see what they have written about our Indian history, that is historiography in the modern period. Now children, in the 20th century, the Indian archaeological exploration and research is started under the British rule. That is, there were many Britishers who were interested to know about our Indian history, about our culture. So in 20th century, the Indian archaeological exploration and research is started under the British rule. Number of sites, ancient sites, they were excavated under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India. So he was interested to know about our Indian culture, about our Indian history. So number of ancient sites, they were excavated. What is excavated? That is basically what they do. The historians or the archaeologists, they used to excavate, that is dig the places or ancient sites where they feel they could get some historical documents or any earthen pots, like that way. So under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham. Now, who was this Sir Alexander Cunningham? He was the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India. So, there are various archaeological departments in our country. Now, what these archaeological departments do? Now, they are in the charge of taking care of the monuments or the ancient buildings, which are the very important sources of history. Sir Alexander Cunningham, he was the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India. And he was interested basically in the sites which were mentioned in the Buddhist text for this purpose. So he was very much interested to know about the sites. He excavated that sites wherein he was interested basically in the Buddhist text. For example, in the Buddhist text we have about the stupas, about the Sanchi stupas, right? So he was interested in the Buddhist text. So he had excavated all the ancient sites where he could find information about the Buddhist period. Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure of Sir John Marshall. Now children, you have learned about the Harappan civilization, that is the Indus Valley civilization, one of the oldest civilization. So Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure of Sir John Marshall, and because of this discovery, the antiquity of Indian history could be traced to 3rd millennium BCE or even earlier. So that is, our history is so old, that is it is traced to 3rd millennium BCE, that is before the Christ era. So Because of the discovery of this discovery by Sir John Marshall, that is about the Harappan civilization, one of the oldest civilization, Indus Valley civilization, Indian history could be traced to 3rd millennium BCE or even earlier than that. Children, there were many British officials in India who had written about our history, about Indian history. But in these writings, whatever they had written, it displayed a strong influence of the colonial policies of the British. Now, what is this colonial policies? The children, they were ruling over a country, right? So whatever, what they felt that their culture is, they had a pride in their culture. Okay, so though they were writing about our country's history, but they had pride in their culture. They felt that their culture is very rich than the Indian culture. Okay, they condemned our culture. Sometimes they had also mocked at our culture, right? So one among them, the British historians, one among them was James Mill. Now they had justified that these Britishers, those who were ruling our country, they justified that their rule is perfect, that they should rule India because Indians are not educated. So we will bring advancement in that country. So our rule in this country, in India, is justified. So one among them was James Mill. He had written 3 volumes of The History of British India, which was published in the year 1817. So the book which is written by James Mill, that is The History of British India, this was the first book which was written on Indian history. But children, this book, it clearly reflects the prejudice against the Indian culture. Now, what is this prejudice? A prejudice means you have an opinion, or you can say a preconceived opinion, about something which have no reason. Means this, you don't have a knowledge of a particular thing. Okay, so it is a preconceived opinion about something without any knowledge or without any thought. So this is very important. That is about the James Mill book. It was the first book on Indian history which was written by a British historian. Okay, that is a history of British India, which was published in 1817, and it was written in 3 volumes. Okay, so that was about James Mill. So whatever he has written, it had a prejudice against the Indian culture. Next is The History of India. Now this was written by Mountstuart Elphinstone. He was a governor of Bombay. Now it is said as Mumbai. And it was published in the year 1841. So here again we have one British historian. Okay. He had written The History of India. Okay. And he was a governor of Bombay. Now it is called as Mumbai. Which was published in the year 1841. The period of Maratha Empire is also very important in Indian history. We all know about our great Maratha leaders, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj, and many more. So, the period of Maratha Empire is also very important in the Indian history. Now here, there is one more historian. His name is Grant Duff. Now, he had wrote the book entitled A History of Marathas. So, very important here about Grant Duff, which book he has written? History of Marathas. Now, children, this book, that is History of Marathas, it was published in 3 volumes. Okay, it was published in 3 volumes. And even Grant Duff's writings, okay, even he had an inclination, or we can say whatever he has written, it is about again condemning the Indian culture and our history. So he has expressed a complete disapproval of Indian culture and history. That is about Grant Duff. So which book he had written? Again, I'll repeat. He has written the book A History of Marathas, which was published in 3 volumes. And even his writings, he has condemned Indian culture and our history. Similar tendency is witnessed in Colonel Todd's writing about Rajasthan's history. Even He has condemned our culture, that is the Rajasthani culture. So similar tendency, and that is how Grant of writing, he has condemned our culture, our history. Similarly, Colonel Tutte's writing about Rajasthan's history also reflect the same thing. There were two volumes written by William Wilson Hunter on Indian history that show somewhat impartial treatment of the subject. Now, it was not like that all the British historians, they had written, they have condemned our culture. Some of them have written whatever was correct. So the two volumes were written by William Wilson Hunter, but he had shown a somewhat impartial treatment of the subject. Now, children, as I told you about Grant Duff, he has written the book A History of Marathas, wherein he has condemned our Indian culture. So there were two Indian historians, that is Neelkant Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade. Now they had decided, they took upon the task of exposing the limitations of Grant Duff's writing. They wanted to preserve their glory, their self-esteem of our culture of Indian history. So they both have decided that they took upon the task of exposing the limitations of Grant Duff's writing. Who are these two Indian historians? Neelkant Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade. Now let us learn about Indian historiography, various ideological frameworks. Now let us learn what is this colonial historiography. Now children, the early scholars who studied and wrote about our Indian history were mainly the British officers and the Christian missionaries. So first, basically the Indian history was written by British officers and the Christian missionaries. Now their prejudice, I already told you what is prejudice, that is you have a preconceived opinion about somebody without any knowledge or reason. So their prejudice is clearly reflected in the way some of them have ridiculed Indian culture. Ridiculed means that they have made fun of, they have mocked at our Indian culture. So their writings were used to justify the colonial British rule, means they feel that their culture was very rich, so Indians should follow their culture. Okay, so the five volumes of Cambridge History of India, published during 1922-1937 CE, are distinct examples of colonial historiography. So which were the five volumes written? Cambridge History of India. It was published during 1937 CE, and they are the distinct examples of colonial historiography. So again I will repeat, the early scholars who had written about the Indian history, they were mainly the British officers and the Christian missionaries, and whatever they have written, it had ridiculed our Indian culture. Their writings, it had justified the colonial rule, that is their culture is very very rich, we should follow their culture. Then there were five volumes written, that is Cambridge History of India. It was published in 1922-1937 CE, and it is a distinct example of colonial historiography. Children, now let us learn about Orientalist historiography. Children, there were many European scholars, they were very curious about our civilizations and countries of the East. Now, Europeans are the Western countries, and they wanted to learn about our civilization. So there were many European scholars, they were very curious about our civilizations and countries of the East. And these scholars, some of those scholars, they had respect for us, they had admiration for our Indian culture. And these scholars were known as Orientalists. So it is not like that all the British historians, they have condemned our culture or had ridiculed our culture. There were some historians, they had a respect for our culture, they had admiration for our culture. So such are known as the Orientalists. These Orientalists, They studied the similarities between the Sanskrit and some of the European languages. Now, they believed that Sanskrit is the mother of all languages. Other languages have been derived from the, or you can say it has come up. The origin of the language is the Sanskrit language. Sanskrit is the mother of all the languages. So, they focused more on the Vedic tradition and Sanskrit literature. They were very much interested with the Sanskrit literature. They studied about that literature, and their studies resulted into formulating notion of an ancient language that could be the mother of all Indo-European languages. So basically, Sanskrit is the mother of all the languages. It is the origin of the language. So these Orientalists, they had studied the similarities between the European languages, okay, and the Sanskrit language. They focused more on the Vedic tradition. They studied all these Vedic traditions. Now, which are our Vedas, children? Rig Veda, we have Yajurva Veda, Atharva Veda, Sama Veda. So, they were interested with that. They studied about that. And they resulted, it resulted into formulating the notion of an ancient language that could be the mother of all the Indo-European languages. In 1784, Sir William Jones, he founded Asiatic Society in Kolkata. Now, this society, it opened the doors for research in ancient Indian literature and history. This you can have as your fill in the blank, children, in your examination. So, you have to study that very carefully. So, in the year 1784, William Jones, he had founded the Asiatic Society in Kolkata. And that society, it had opened the doors for research in Indian history and literature. Now, children, among the Orientalist scholars, Frederick Max Müller, he deserves a special mention. Now, he was very much interested in Sanskrit literature. Okay, so his name deserves a special mention when we study about the Orientalist historiography. Now, in his opinion, according to him, Sanskrit was the most ancient language of Indo-European languages. So, as I told you, he was very much interested in the Sanskrit literature. So, according to him, Sanskrit was the ancient language of the Indo-European languages. And he has translated the Sanskrit text of Hitopadesh. Now, children, you have learnt about the Panchatantra, stories of the animals, fables that give you the moral. They are the moral stories. So, he has translated the Sanskrit text of Hitopadesh. He was the editor of 50 volumes of the sacred books of the East. Okay, he compiled Rig Veda, which has been published in 6 volumes. So he had studied that Sanskrit literature, and he has then also translated Rig Veda into German. So even German people, they learned about our culture, that is about our Sanskrit literature. So he had translated Hitopadesh, and also he has translated Rig Veda into German. Therefore, Frederick Max Müller names deserves a special mention when we learn about Orientalist historiography. Lately, Edward said he was a scholar and who has re-evaluated the Orientalist his writings, and he has thrown light on imperialistic interest of Orientalist scholars. What do you mean by imperialism? Now, imperialism means, children, when a country has a control over another country in the form of colonies, and they feel that they are ruling them for their interest. They will give them good education and make them more and more modern. So he has re-evaluated the Orientalist writings, and he has thrown light on the imperialistic interest of the Orientalist scholars. So children, today we had learned about the historiography in the modern period, that what the British historians have written about our culture, many have ridiculed it, many were interested with the Sanskrit literature. Okay, so we had learnt about so many British historians today, those who were interested in our culture. They have written so many volumes of books, okay, about our Indian history and culture. So we had learned today about the historiography in the modern period. Now, children, there's a small activity for you. I want you all that you have to write all this in your notebooks. Now children, I have given you the names of the historians and the book which they have written. Now for example, James Mill, he was the one who has written the history of British India. This was the first book, right, written on Indian history. Then I want you to write what was the name of the book written by James Grantham. And here in the third one, I have given you the name of the book, that is the History of India. I want you to write the historian who had written this book. Because children, such type of questions, they appear in the board examination. So you should learn all the name of the historians and which books they have written. That is a historiography in the modern period. In that you will get all the names of the historians, British historians, who have written the books on Indian history, Indian culture. Okay, so now children, I hope you have understood what we have learned today. Please start revising, learn all the answers in points. Okay, you have to write all the answers in points again and again. I repeat in my same class, again and again I repeat in the class that you have to write in the points. That is very important when you write your history paper. Okay, so children, thank you my dear students, and we will meet in the next class. Have a good day, my dear children.